Hello, welcome to a DrChrono tutorial. DrChrono has partnered with Ironbridge to help connect our primary care and immunizing providers to all state immunization registries with one integration. Through this partnership, our customers will be able to easily and quickly connect to their practice's state registry to submit applied and historical vaccine data, as well as query forecasted or upcoming vaccinations for the patient and their historical immunizations. This video will demonstrate how to enter and submit a vaccination record, as well as query for forecasted and historical vaccinations and immunizations. Let's begin. Before I demonstrate how to submit a vaccine record, it is important to note that it is required to have data entered in specific fields for patient demographics and the IIS publicity profile. This is in order to successfully send a submission. Blank fields will generate an error message that can be seen in the message center, which will detail which required fields are missing. Once these fields have been entered, you will no longer have to do so going forward. Now let's move on to the required fields within the patient demographics. Under the Important tab, the required fields are the patient's first name, last name, and either the home phone number, cell phone, office phone, or email address. Under demographics, the required fields are the patient's date of birth, sex, race, ethnicity, the patient's full address, including the country, and if the patient has a responsible party, the required fields under this section should be entered as well. Now, let's move on to the IIS publicity profile required fields. We'll navigate to immunizations, and then once under immunizations, we'll skip over to the jump to and select IIS publicity profile. This will bring you to the immunization profile page. ID number and mother's maiden name are optional. However, the remaining fields are required. Once these fields have been entered, we can now go ahead and submit a vaccine to sync with the state registry. From the Immunizations tab, you will see your Step 1, Step 2, and Step 3 options. This particular patient has vaccine records under the Other section, and as you can see, there have been some vaccine records already sent to the registry, which indicates here under the Registry Sync column. And what we will do is we will go ahead and submit another vaccine to save locally, like this example. Once I've chosen my vaccine, I will scroll to the bottom here and select vaccines. If there were any vaccine information statements that would present here, you would be able to actually view that statement and check the box. You will have the option to skip, sign a consent form, or upload the consent form. Step 3. Here I can see any existing immunization consent forms, and I can also scroll down now and enter the vaccine record. I can fill in my current status. The entire section is required. The CVX code section is required to enter in and enter in your lot information. Below you'll have an option to either save and sync to the registry or simply save. Saving will save the record to the DrChrono platform. However, if there are any particular saved vaccines that have been saved locally to DrChrono and they are within the administered threshold date, so either on this date or after, the user can come back in and click Save and Sync to Registry, and all of the saved local vaccines will then be sent to the registry. If I want to see which vaccines are existing, I can come back to step one. And here I can see all that have been sent to the registry, as well as those vaccine records that have been saved locally. If I do want to send a separate vaccine separately and not just in a bulk, I can just come and send by clicking this icon and have that separate vaccine just sent by itself. If there's any missing information, the vaccine record will save locally, and you can review in the message center what the missing required fields are. So under all messages within the message center, you'll locate the message that states we could not submit your vaccine record. So that would be the title. And below you would see the information that's required and that's missing in order to successfully send that vaccine to the registry. There's also another option where you can view any history records for your patient, as well as forecasted vaccinations. And that is by clicking on History and Forecast, selecting your requesting office, and searching. Once you click search, you will be able to see the forecast schedule for that patient, as well as the record history. This concludes demonstrating how to enter and submit a vaccination record, as well as query for forecasted and historical vaccinations and immunizations. I hope that this video was helpful. You can also reference our existing knowledge base articles for any additional information.